me Anushka, welcome back to my channel. I had taken a short break from YouTube and the first video after this break had to be from the NIFT series because the NIFT entrance results are finally out and congratulations to all of you because your exams are finally over and the results are also out. So half of the tension that you guys have been feeling all this while is finally out of the window. But I know ki abhi bhi bahut sari confusion hai and in this video I aim to combat all that confusion. This video is going to be about the NIFT counseling, as you already know from the title, and I hope you enjoy watching this video. And without any further ado, let's get started. So the first confusion that I'm going to address is one of the most general and common confusion that you guys have. It is the difference between common merit rank and category merit rank. So common merit rank is the rank that you have obtained based on your performance in all over India, and category merit rank is the rank that you have obtained based on your performance within the particular category that you belong to. This rank only applies for reserved categories like SC, ST, OBC and PWD. For students who belong to the general category, your category merit rank is basically of no use. And for those who belong to the reserved category, you will be called for counseling and allotted the seats based on your category merit rank. And for the students who belong to the general category, you will be called for the counseling and allotted the seats based on your common merit rank. Moving on, I have been receiving so many DMs and so many messages regarding what department and center you might get into based on the rank that you have obtained. So let me tell you that I am nobody to decide that, and your center and department cannot really be predicted at the moment. All of this depends on which center and department are those students going to choose as counseling is going to come before you. However, to get a rough idea of which center and department you can probably get into, you can have a look at this document called Last Merit Rank, which is put up on the NIFT's official website every year before the counseling, and it gives information about the last rank that was admitted in each department and center in each category last year. So by looking at it, you can get some rough idea that your rank can fetch you with center and department. Also, the availability of seats in each department and center is constantly updated on the NIFT's official website after each counseling day gets over. So make sure to remain updated with the website. Now coming to the process of the counseling, it's very easy, but before you go for your counseling, you need to register yourself. I think the registration has started already, but if not, then the dates of registration will be out soon. And on the day of the registration, you just need to visit the NIFT's official website, put in some necessary details, and then choose a center for your counseling. The counseling center does not really matter. You can choose any NIFT center of your choice, preferably the one which is closest to the place you stay. The center does not matter at all. It is nothing like ki agar tum NIFT Delhi mein counseling ke liye jaoge to tumhare NIFT Delhi mein seat milne ke chances badh jayenge. The counseling for all the centers takes place at the same time using one single portal. So even if you go to NIFT Shillong for your counseling and you have a rank that can fetch you a seat in NIFT Delhi or NIFT Mumbai, you'll be able to do so. The registration does not require any fee, and once you've completed the registration, you'll be emailed the details of the NIFT center that you have chosen for the counseling, such as address and contact details, and you'll be also shared information about the nodal officer of that NIFT center. You can contact the nodal officer in case if you have any problem regarding the documents or any confusion for that matter. We'll also be shared a document soon which has all the counseling dates and a list of documents that you need to carry on the day of the counseling. These documents are usually your mark sheets from class 10th and 12th, certificates and so on. Make sure to carry all the documents and annexures without any fail. On the day of the counseling, make sure to reach the venue 30 minutes prior. Upon reaching the counseling venue, your documents will be checked. That is the first thing that you do. And once you're done with the document check and everything, you just need to sit outside with all the other students. There will be this huge projector TV screen in front of you which will give you the live updates regarding the seat availability in each center and department. So you can have a look at that, and when your turn comes in, you just need to go inside, submit all your documents if you haven't already, and go to the computer and select the department and NIFT center of your choice. It is very easy, it is not difficult at all, and there'll be people to assist you constantly. You just make sure ki tum sahi department or sahi center pe tick kar rahe ho, and that's all. So that's all about the basic and general information that you need to have about the NIFT counseling. In case if you have any more doubts regarding the procedure of the counseling, you can DM me or leave your queries in the comment section below. For those of you who have obtained a rank above 2000 or 1500 for that matter, don't get your hopes too high, because all the seats usually get over by 1500 or 2000. But it's not the end of life. Start thinking of backup options. Wait for the counseling day and wait, look at the availability of seats. Meanwhile, also think of some backup options. One question that I've been getting a lot is that whether you should choose a department over a particular center or vice versa. Personally, I feel it's always preferable to choose a department over any center, because I was really passionate about doing fashion communication and I had made up my mind that I would take up fashion communication no matter which center I was getting a seat in. There have been instances when people take up any random department just to get into a good center and then feel stuck up later on. So it's always preferable to choose a department, because that is something that you are passionate about and want to move ahead in life with. So personally, I feel you should always prefer your department over any center. Another question that I keep on getting every now and then, and which kind of irritates me sometimes, I'm really sorry if you have been on the receiving end of my irritation when you're asking that question. The question is that if you received an All India Rank 5, why did you take up a seat in NIFT Mumbai and not NIFT Delhi? Firstly, I took up fashion communication in NIFT Mumbai because it is the best in Mumbai in terms of the teaching and also the opportunities and placements. This is what I learned from all my teachers and my coaching centers and from some research that I did on the web. So that is why I took up fashion communication in NIFT Mumbai and not in NIFT Delhi. Also, it's a personal choice, so I think it shouldn't be questioned every now and then. But yeah, basically I took fashion communication in NIFT Mumbai because it's the best there. So that's all for today's video. In case if this video was helpful, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching, and until next time, bye!